should pay all the bills, even from day one.
I like this.
From day one. You have to remember, what type of presentation are you presenting to a woman? Hey, I'm this dude that wants you to come in the situation and you do you and I do me. What's the point of being with somebody? You should do this on literally on date number one, right? Cool. Oh, you got a car note. Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. This and that. Have your own before you start dating. That way, when you meet a young lady, it's immediately like, hey, I'm gonna take care of this, 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 this. It's not you being paymaster. It's you saying, you're with me, you are with me. You're not with them no more. Now imagine if you take over and you say, no, I got this, this, and this. That lets that woman know that you are not playing any games and you are serious about getting it with her. What I hate the most is paying half the rent. Because even some ladies say, no, I agree. I suppose it's split half the rent. That's because you never met a real man, boo-boo.
Yes.
If you would have met a real man, he would never let you pay all the bills or even half.
No in, no touch. Uh-uh. No voting, no nothing. No voting, no fucking, no voting, no fucking.
BLK app looking for some action. Swear the homie Scott was heading. Hey. Face is a 9, abs a 10. D is a to be determined. He got mad jokes. He don't seem broke. The only red flag, he said he don't vote. This midterms for all the single cuties. Wanna hit this booty, gotta do your civic duty.
No voting, no loving. No voting, no touch. No voting, no nothing. No voting, no fucking, no voting, no fucking. No voting, no loving. No voting, no touch.
Am I the meanest?
Sure enough.
Am I the prettiest?
Sure enough.
Am I the baddest mofo low down around this town?
Sure enough.
Well, who am I?
Sure enough.
Who am I?
Sure enough.
I can't hear you.
Sure enough.
Shogun. Yes. Crunch. Seats.
This is Show's Row. Move.
I said beat it!
Let's start off by giving this nigga his flowers and shit. And in case you didn't know, this is a pussy, okay? This is a fucking pussy and shit. And this is one of the reasons that, you know, I follow the teachings of Neely Fuller and shit in part. You know, when he says don't have nothing to do with any Negro, that it ain't doing nothing productive and shit, okay? This is bullshit. This guy's bullshit. I'm not going to say he doesn't believe all that crap, but he's a guru, all right? He's some kind of, you know, millionaire guru and shit that has made his family rich. He's taking them from Section 8 to a mansion and shit. You know, I forgot, I think a couple of $1 million mansion or whatever. That property tax is a motherfucker, okay? But he's made everyone in his family rich and blah, 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 blah. Somewhere in there is a pyramid and shit, I would suspect. And a lot of gullible fucking people and shit. All right? This is a pussy, okay? And, you know, with all that fucking money that you supposedly have to pay bills and do all this shit, you know, with all that money, you could not buy your wife a fucking hairline, okay? Can you buy your wife a decent hairline? That shit is sitting in the middle of her head. I haven't seen a hairline that bad since James Earl Jones shit in a fucking Meteor Man. Okay? That's where we're going here. Okay, bro? All right? Yeah, this guy's a millionaire guru and all that shit. Whatever money he has or doesn't have, the, you know, really doesn't matter here. It's the advice that he's giving to the potential, you know, kings and shit, they might see this and get the wrong, you know, just get the wrong impression. You do not buy the affection of a woman and shit, okay? That's like leasing a car. If you have to, you know, engage in transactional behavior and shit with somebody, might as well just get a professional. You might as well just buy a prostitute, okay? For lack of a better term. I was going to say some shit like call girl or something like that, but the lines are getting so blurred and shit. Now, we live in a world where, like, a hoochie, a chicken head, like an old-school chicken head can travel to Dubai and shit to get, you know, to be a porta-potty for some sheik. And I think it's shitty, okay? I think you need a code of conduct in our community. Because, like, you know, a lot of women do travel and, you know, get out and everything. That's not what this commentary is about, but I would like to touch on that. A lot of women do travel abroad and shit. You know, they don't have no kind of formal education or home training or manners or any kind of upbringing and shit. And that's why motherfuckers in other countries see you the way they see you. And that's why you've played yourself into a service class and shit. And that's why you're at the bottom of the totem of why people who would marry you and shit. Okay, you have to settle for, you know, bottom shelf bread and you being a sugar baby if you're good enough. You know? This guy is a pussy, okay? I can't say it any other kind of way. You know, I'm sorry if that's cringe to some people and shit. But he's non-select and he has to, you know, pay for his ticket. He has to pay for his golden ticket to that worn-out, busted-ass peace sleeve machine. You better take those rose-colored glasses off and see what's going on here, okay? He's got a little podcast and shit. He's got a little bullshit going on. He just got a business, you know, it's somewhat successful for now and shit, but I will tell that guy that when he goes over $10 million, so you better start looking over his shoulder for the IRS and shit, because that's when the minority majority start coming after you. When you go past that line and shit, that invisible line of success and shit, where they can't tolerate it, you know? They could tolerate it below a certain level, but not now and shit. And it's not important. He's up here telling motherfuckers to pay for a woman's attention. To pay for a woman's attention and shit. How do you feel doing that, okay? Do you wonder why I use an avatar of an old school arcade, you know, game and shit? Old school arcade game. Do you wonder why I use it now? It's because Negroes like this and shit, okay? And I want to talk about the passport shit again, okay? A lot of motherfuckers like this is going to go overseas and fuck around and shit over there and make it look like kind of dangerous for regular guys that's actually trying to do something and shit, okay? I want to put that out there, you know, because I heard about, I think about 4 years ago, I was listening to a podcast. I'm not going to say the content creators. It's a Man of Spirit guy. He was talking about how guys were complaining that these simps were going to foreign countries and making it rain and fucking up the ecosystem and shit over there. And, you know, I just got to tell you young kings out there, you're going to have to go a little bit further than they can go. And you're going to have to outlast their vacation money and shit so you can get a real experience and shit, okay? Don't let anyone discourage you from what you want to do and shit. And do not stay over here and fuck around, you know, with some female. Some, you know, this is how you get, like, some of these fucked up females, like, thinking... This is how you get some really messed up chicks thinking that you should pay for their time and shit. And I mean really fucked up ones and shit. This guy is part of the problem, okay? He's not the solution. You can't learn anything useful from him. You know, maybe he can tell you how to, you know, run a scam to become a millionaire and shit. Because he's running a scam right now. Running a scam on black women and shit. This is he has a little YouTube channel, has a couple hundred subscribers on it. We're running neck and neck right now. Let's put it that way. All right? And he has this million-dollar business. You know, it's a system. You know, I love when they use these buzzwords like system and classes and all that shit. You're going to pay a hefty price for the class. You're going to get some bullshit. Ain't going to keep adding dollars. Okay? That's what's going to happen. And this is a cash grab and shit. This is meant to attract American black women and shit, and whoever else has that fucked up transactional mindset to his YouTube channel, so that he can get clicks and likes and ultimately make a living off of the platform and shit, okay? Just want to put it out there. We're telling the straight up truth. I have nothing to lose or gain either way and shit, but I just can't let him fuck over brother and shit. That's a cardinal sin and shit, as far as I'm concerned, amongst black men and shit. Like, If you would trivialize and waste another man's time and shit, you deserve no mercy. You deserve whatever karma you get. Okay? And I ain't got nothing to say. I just could call this guy like the biggest pussy in the world and shit for giving out such advice and shit about paying bills and all this shit. You are not required to pay any bills of anyone you are not legally married to. Okay? And even if you have a kid, you're not required to do anything other than pay for the child's upbringing and shit. And you need to stay on a female's bumper if they get your seed and shit, okay? Keep your fucking head on the swivel. Watch your you know, watch your finances and shit, especially and shit, okay? There ain't nobody out here. Everybody want to be a fucking Disney princess and shit, but they're not, okay? They're not that. They're like that fat bitch in that Little Mermaid movie. Like a fucking Ursula out there. All right? And you got guys like this and shit. He's a fucking loser. He leads with his wallet. He has to buy the pussy and shit. This is the kind of guy I used to see back in the day in the fucking 90s at a club and shit, going up to some hot chick and shit. She ignored the motherfucker. And then he pull out a bunch of money and start like putting it like in front of her and shit until she capitulates. Say, okay, well, you know, all right. Well, I can always bend over and not look at his face and shit, you know. I see a lot of women. I know transactional women and shit. I met transactional women. I saw bone transactional women without giving them shit. You gonna listen to this fucking guy? He's telling you that you should be ready to pay all her bills on the first date. Man. Hey, if you do that shit, I want you to hit me up in the comments section and tell me how the fuck you look at yourself in the mirror in the morning and shit, okay? Whether you get the drawers or not. How do you look yourself in the mirror and shit? I don't give no fucking dating advice here. I get like wellness advice and shit. You keep your fucking head on swivel. Protect your seed. Make sure you strap up. Okay? Don't give them nothing. Do not make that Faustian deal. Whatever this guy is talking about is a road to the fucking matrix and shit. You're going to be in that goddamn system. Whether you like it or not and shit. And your dreams are going to die and shit. Okay? And you're going to be paying. You're not just paying her tab and shit. All right? You're paying a minority majority's tab with this nonsense. This guy is not wealthy, okay? He's rich, but he's not wealthy. He's nigga rich, okay? Yes, I said it. He's nigga rich and shit. That's, you know, we're basically look at him. It's a fucking joke. Tell me he's not a joke and shit. This is the kind of motherfuckers that are reproducing themselves. This is what black women are reproducing with and then expecting you to come in and be like a janitor and clean up this mess once everything hits the fan and shit. This dude behind bars on some kind of charges and shit. And then it's your turn and shit, okay? You know, when her money run out or the money she steals from this dude after he's behind bars runs out, she's going to be looking for you with them kids. Get the fuck out. All right, and this guy's a pussy. I haven't said that enough. He's giving you bad advice and shit, okay? He's a guru. The money guru. He's really wealthy, right? This guy is so rich, man. He's living in the X mansion, you know, with a hoochie who he has yet to purchase her a decent hairline. You can't even get her a partial piece, you know, like a little bob thing, a little piece of hair to put over that receding hairline and shit. And he looks like a clown. Look how he's dressed. Look at him. He looks like a giant kid. You can tell who's rich and who's nigga rich and shit. Okay, let's talk about the 1%. You know, let's see Jeff Bezos wearing shit like this. Anyway, I'm done, okay? You know, do what you want to do and shit, you know? It's only advice.
Extraterrestrials. Strange phenomena. Missing persons. Lost continents, myths, and monsters.
We examine these mysteries to determine, are they bullshit or not?
What's going on, y'all? My name is Trey First Class, and right now I am on the set of Love and Riches podcast. Take a look at it. Go ahead and go over a couple of things that's going on here. So right here, we have camera C. This is our third camera angle. This is camera A. This is our main shot for the wide shot over here. This is camera B. It's gonna be focused on Olivia and Keenan over here. And then we got Ty, Mr. One Center. It's gonna be sitting right here. All right, we are filming episode 5 today. Episode 5. Make sure you guys follow the YouTube channel, Love and Riches. Subscribe, watch the other episodes. Listen to the episodes on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, and all the above. All right, we'll see y'all, episode 5.
I agree. I suppose it's split half the rent. That's because you never met a real man, boo-boo.
Yes.
If you would have met a real man, he would never let you pay all the bills or even half should pay all the bills, even from day one.
I like this.
From day one. You have to remember, what type of presentation are you presenting to a woman? Hey, I'm this dude that wants you to come in the situation and you do you and I do me. What's the point of being with somebody? You should do this on literally on date number one, right? Cool.